Professor Sarah Agbor, Commissioner Human Resources, Science and Technology of the African Union, has urged participants at Human Resource Science and Technology's four-day Congress to be committed to achieving the Agenda 2063 of the African Union. Agbor gave the advice in Abuja while addressing participants at the second Congress of the African Scientific Research and Innovation Council, entitled Freeing Africa from Hunger, Poverty and Diseases. She said Agenda 2063 is African Union's blueprint and master plan for transforming Africa into the global powerhouse of the future.
I said Agenda 2063 is that vision of the Africa we want by 2063. It started in 2013 and it's a 50-year plan divided into five phases of 10 years each. This agenda was developed to address developmental challenges in Africa. The framework and its own aspirations cannot be achieved without sectoral strategies and policies such as the Science Technology Innovation Strategy for Africa, which we commonly refer to as CISA 2024.
She stressed the need for participants to manifest the Pan-African drive to achieve unity, freedom, progress and collective prosperity, which will help to strengthen the science and technology sector in Africa. Agbor also emphasized the need for innovative and bankable projects that address market and community needs, with the view of moving millions of Africans out of poverty and free from diseases through job creation.
Scientists in this house, if our research does not respond to the need of our people, if our research is not functional to the challenges of our society, definitely the Africa we want cannot be envisioned and realized by 2063. That is why ASRIC was created to galvanize African scientists home and abroad to a new dawn of the Africa we want, where we talk about complementarity and not competition, where what matters is how we can concretely change the narrative of mediocrity and science for the shelves, and change of great, but research that leads to development, research that can boost health, improve agricultural produce, upscale the supply of water, energy, and create a conducive environment for our great people. And the young scientists here present, the baton has been given to us. Africa is us, and together we can make Africa work. If Africa is born in you, you will be committed to the cause of development. You will be committed to the cause of sacrificing and bringing the very best to this continent so that our kids and our children will not die in the Mediterranean. They will not die in the Sahara, because then we make Africa a paradise. We will no longer speak the Canadian diaspora or the Canadian dream or the British dream or the American dream. We will speak of Africa. Africa, my Africa. Africa of those proud warriors in ancestral savannas. Africa is us, but we must lead Africa to that destination of the transformation of the Africa we want.
For his part, the Burundian ambassador to Nigeria called for proper funding of science innovations in Africa to develop and boost modern technology in the continent. He said proper funding of research projects will bring innovation to the entire continent with the goal of freeing Africa from poverty, hunger, and diseases.
I believe this fund will bring innovation to the entire continent with a goal of freeing Africa from poverty, hunger, and diseases. It's my personal belief that Africa have research projects which lack proper funding. I believe African scientists can achieve what other scientists of other parts of the world achieve. I do believe that Africa scientists have nothing to envy other scientists of the other parts of the world, except proper funding. I do believe I cannot do it by myself. I'm with a very empowered committee and the experienced people who are committed to do like me, and together we're going to do a good job of mobilizing the funds so that the Africa could be free from poverty, hunger, and diseases.